Hey guys, hope you all are doing good and safe. Last week I have launched my digital planner. Lots of people bought that, but few of you are little bit confused how to edit this. And already I have promised you to make this tutorial that how you can edit digital planner with a free app. And you guys have lots of questions, so I'm going to tell you again. This is a digital planner. You can buy just one time and you can edit for years until you get bored of it. So without further ado, let's jump onto the video. You have to type Sajda PDF editor. It is absolutely free. Before you upload any PDF file, you will copy and paste your downloaded file in desktop. This file you will get from me. You will save it in some folder, but when you have to use every day, better to save another copy in desktop. Now you will go to Sajda again and click on the upload file, select the desktop file. Now the whole file is here. You will get all 39 pages. Now let's edit. Left side you will see delete option. This particular page will be deleted if you click that. Then you will see zoom in and zoom out option. Then rotate option, which you don't need. Now let's see the top options: text, links, forms, image, sign, whiteout, annotate, shape and more. Now let's start writing. Then one by one I will tell you what options you need for writing. Once you will select the text and click anywhere, the text will appear. Here you can see 6 options: bold, italic, font size, font style, color and delete. Wherever you will click, the text will be created. That's why it is better once you are done, click outside. Every month you have to put it manually. You can use this planner as long as you want. This is not a physical planner that after 6 months or 1 year you have to buy another one. This is just a one-time investment. With one-time purchase you can use many years. Then I am writing my goals of this month. If you want, you can add interactive forms. Here I am adding bullets. You can nicely decorate this. Now I'm writing to-do list for this month. If you want to highlight any goal which is important, go to a note and select highlight color, then highlight the goal. You can delete it also. Now I'm writing the appointments. I have lots of birthdays in this month, including my birthday. Now I'm writing this month will be, if you want handwritten font, that also you will get it here. You have to go to sign option. There you have to write the sentence you want to write. Select the font and paste it. This is how you can create your own page. In next page, you can write what are the skills you want to learn, or what are the movies you want to watch, or what are the new things you want to try, new books you want to read, etc. The next page is mental health tracker, where you are going to track your mental health condition. For that I am going to zoom this page because you have to draw a line. Here you can see each dots means each days. So directly you will go to Anote and you will select the draw line. You can select any color and you will draw the line like this. The line is thick. You can make it thin by pressing ESC, then select the line, then you will see the thickness, then you can select thickness according to your choice. Now I'm doing same thing for other days. So basically you have to draw the line of your stress level. Like if you have extreme stress on second day of August, then you are going to draw the line till extreme. Then next day if you have little bit stress, then you can draw the line till low. Like this way you have to draw the line. Same thing for overthinking and emotional pain also. Mood tracker will be little bit different, because here you will see bad, good and awesome. First day if your mood is awesome, then you are going to draw the line till awesome. If second day your mood is bad, then you are going to draw the line till bad, like this. Now move on to next page, which is my favorite page. Here I'm going to zoom the page, because here you have to feel the color. So whatever habits you want to track, you are going to write it. I'm writing here meditation, journaling, hydration, skincare, read one page every day, etc. So now I'm changing the color. Now I'm going to anode and select the highlight. Now I'm going to fill the boxes. I never skip meditation and journaling, so I know there won't be any empty box. If you want, you can change the color. Last 2 days I'm not having 8 glasses of water, so that's why 3rd and 4th day I kept the boxes empty. Till 4th day I have done skincare properly, and only 1st August I just read the book. Now move on to sleep tracker. So again you have to select either draw or highlight. You have to draw line like this way. You can change the thickness. If you want, you can change the color. So basically you have to draw the line. First day I have slept 12 o'clock and I woke up next day 7 a.m. So like this way you have to draw the line. When you will start doing by yourself, automatically you will get to know how this application works. It is very easy software to edit. Actually you don't need tutorial for this. My next page is self-care checklist. Basically you don't have to do anything here. Every day you will go through the page and you will see what kind of activity you can do that day. If you want, you can add some bullet like you have done this activity, or if you want to highlight any habit you like, you can highlight that. So basically you don't need to do anything in this page. Next page is one line for every day. So this is very simple. You just select the text and you write a highlight of the day. One line for every day. Next, move on to monthly budget. Here in source, you are going to write the source of income. Like if you are doing job, then job. Then in amount category, you are going to write your salary. If you have business, then you are going to write the business, then the amount, and you are going to calculate the total. Then in expenses, you're going to write all your expenses, and then you're going to make the total. In savings category, you are going to write the total income minus total expenses equal to the saving. And in notes category, you can write like maybe this month I have saved more, or I have saved less than previous month, etc. Next page is today's schedule. Left side you can see weather. Go to the shape weather and draw the circle. Then right side you will see the date. You are going to write the date. Then affirmation of the day. Then to-do list. Then in schedule you are going to write in detail when you are going to wake up, when you are going to have breakfast, from what time to what time you are going to work, etc. Then right side you will see appointments and top 3 priorities. You are going to write your top 3 priorities. Then in meal planner category, you are going to write what you are going to cook that day, breakfast, lunch, dinner or snacks. Then rate your day, you are going to select the shape again. You draw the circle and you can feel the color by selecting any color. Now you can copy paste. Suppose your day was great, so you are going to rate 5, or if your day is bad, then you are going to rate 1, like this. Same thing for did I walk for my goals and exercise. For water, you can select each glass you had that day, or directly you can draw the line like this. And you are going to write gratitude, today's accomplishment, and notes and doodles. Then you will get same page for 31 days. You have to go to the last page, which is monthly review question. You are going to answer this question end of the month. In my previous video, I have talked about all questions, so you can check that video. So this is how you are going to fill your digital planner. Now I'm going to tell you how to save. You can see apply changes. So once you click that, you will get one window. It says found type your text edits, remove before continuing. Every day you are going to edit this planner, so select the keep option and it will show your task is processing. Now you will get your document is ready. Now you have to download the file. Once it is downloaded, copy the file, again paste in the desktop and replace the file in the destination. So your edited file is replaced already. Now when you are going to open the same file, replaced file, you will see the edited file. So next day you can continue editing. Again, you will do the same process. I hope you understand this video. If you didn't understand, it is very easy. Once you start editing this page, you will automatically get to know how to do this thing. And if you have any questions, you can comment down below. If you want to buy this planner, already lots of people bought my planner. Thank you so much for that. If you want to buy this planner, please mail me. I will tell you how to do the payment. And you can start writing this digital planner anytime. So I hope you all like this video. I will see you guys in my next video. Till then, bye.